Hare Krishna. Regulate emotion with reason and animate reason with emotion. Reason and emotion are often seen to be opposites in our inner world. By reason, we can be logical, sequential, systematic. By emotion, we tend to be intuitive, we tend to be spontaneous, we tend to be unorganized or disorganized. So, now sometimes we may veer towards one or other side based on our nature. Some people are much more rational and some people are much more emotional. We need a balance of both to function effectively. So we need to regulate emotion with reason. Our emotions can drive us wild. And if we do not wish to be driven wild, then we need absolutely, urgently to regulate our emotion with reason. So that means that our emotion, if it makes us very dejected or it makes us very elated, then either way, the such extremes are not healthy. So we regulate our emotion with reason. Reason means we understand that actually whatever happens in life and whatever emotions it triggers in us, they're all temporary. They'll come, they will go. Nothing in life lasts forever. So 5.20 in the Bhagavad-Gita points to such regulation of emotion by reason when it says, Na praharishet priyam prapya, no dvijet prapya cha priyam, sthira buddhir asammoodho, brahma vid brahmani sthitaha. Don't become elated on getting something good. Don't become dejected on getting something bad. Just stay steady, undeluded, with fixed intelligence by realizing your spirituality. Now, while the Bhagavad Gita talks about a very unemotional kind of spirituality, not getting excited or dejected, but the Bhagavad Gita is also a book of bhakti, and bhakti is an emotion. So the idea is that the emotions that take us away from bhakti, we need to regulate them. And for that we use our reason, our philosophical reason, our scripturally grounded reason. And then the Gita also talks about emotion in a positive sense. It talks about how a devotee offers one's heart to Krishna. Krishna reveals his own heart. Krishna, when he is giving us philosophical instruction, he doesn't just give analysis. Along with giving analysis, he also conveys his affection, his intense care for Krishna. And thus he says, Iti te jnanam akhyatam guhyat guhyataram maya vimrishaitadasheshena yathechasi tatha kuru. So he appeals to Arjuna to use his reason to deliberate on the highly confidential knowledge that he has given. And then take action. That means not just let one's actions be determined by one's emotions alone, but do deliberation, use reason. So he is, in 18.63, calling for the regulation of emotion with reason. But then if we see 64, 65, 66, he is animating reason with emotion when he says, Sarva guhyatam ambhuyah shrunume paramam vachah ishtosime drudhamiti tato vakshamite hitam. Now I'll speak the most confidential knowledge to you because you are most dear to me. Ishtosime drudhamiti, you are dearly loved by me. Tato vakshamite hitam. Therefore, for your benefit, I will speak it. And the same mood, he emphasizes the next verse also. And thus, he actually helps us. He infuses his philosophical reason with devotion, with loving emotion. And as Krishna reveals, so does the devotee reciprocate. And so when we also use our reason to serve Krishna, to connect with Krishna in the practice of bhakti, then for us, reason is not just a cold, calculative tool for knowing what is right and wrong. For us, reason is a means for connecting with the Lord, who is the source of all joy, who is the source of sublime emotion, who is the ocean of devotional animation. So when with whatever devotional emotion we have, we animate our reason, then that reason, when it is coupled with emotion, Krishna, then we will be able to connect with Krishna and not let the reason dominate and make us calculative, cold-hearted, but it will make us balanced as well as absorbed in Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.